Morning! Welcome to this, the last episode in this series. But don't worry, there's more vlogs coming. Today, I am heading to Animal Kingdom with my friends, the Cheers Ears. That's Keith, Tracy, Luke and Daisy, which you might recognise from my April 2023 series where we did Pop Century for a whole week and I combined that whole series into one big long vlog. So if you want to go and watch that first and know who they are, feel free. I am currently sporting a lovely salmon outfit today. Ooh la la. We haven't really got many plans apart from going with the flow at Animal Kingdom and then dinner at the Flying Fish, which is on the boardwalk in the Epcot area. So I'm looking forward to going there. I've been there once, but it was a long time ago. So I'm interested to see what it's like today. Did I turn my strainers off? Yes. Cabbage. I like to say a random word for each thing I need to turn off. That way when I go away, I was like, did I say cabbage this morning? So that's why I do that. Let the fun begin. These elevators are great for social anxiety because if you don't want to be in lift with people, you just wait a minute and then you can push the lift and you'll probably get a lift to yourself.
Why am I like this? Why am I like this? Why am I like this? Why am I?
I've got to tell you, the weather this week has been probably the best weather I've ever had in Orlando. There's been a breeze every day. It's maybe been 28, 29, but the humidity's been really low. And
nice flowers.
Just October is such a nice time of year, and if you time it right, you can get weather like this. You may also end up with hurricanes and stuff like that, so just, you know, good morning. Have a good day. We're just a few days away from November, and if you look over there, they have started installing the Christmas decorations. And a fun fact for you, Disney has a team that work on Christmas decorations all year round, so even though they're not in the parks, when they're in the warehouses and stuff like that, they're already prepping decorations for new things that have been added. So for example, Moana Journey of Water, that could get like a Christmas garland or something. They need to build that during the year. And also they need to do repairs on the ones that have been damaged, you know, storms and that kind of stuff. They take a toll on all the nice things that they stick up. But yeah, like they might have to repaint those and that kind of stuff. There used to be a backstage tour where you could actually go and see the Christmas storage warehouse. I never did it. I don't think it's returned since the shutdowns and everything like that. But Disney, if you're watching, I would love to have a movie shrew around all the Christmas things.
Oh my God, it's Cheers Ears. Hello.
Oh God, it's Adam Hattan from YouTube.
Break dance.
Okay. I can't commit to this bit.
This cast member's doing it though.
We were walking to Expedition Everest because it was 20 minutes. If it's over 30 minutes, I'm like, and so it's 35, and I was like, and they were like, oh, we're still gonna do it. And I was like, Tracy, what are you doing? And then she was like, I'm not doing it. I was like, me and Tracy are gonna go and do something fun. So, bye.
Now we've got to do something fun.
Should we get ice cream?
Yeah, let's do that.
I'm going to get a frozen banana covered in chocolate. What are you going to get?
I'm torn between that and the strawberry fruit bar.
Treat yourself. We've come into the theatre where Rivers of Light used to play. And we're going to sit in the shade.
So it's longer.
Hi.
You have the discovery of Isaac.
We've stopped into the Yak and Yeti quick service. I've ordered myself a honey sesame chicken with fried rice and a Coke, which came to $29.37. Quite expensive for a quick service, if I'm honest. Here's a look at the menu.
Honey sesame chicken. This is the portion of the chicken fried rice. It's not massive, but it is really, really, really lovely. Luke went for the
salad. Chicken teriyaki salad.
Nice. Daisy's got the same as me. Same as Tracy, same as Keith. Great minds think alike.
I know. Dino Land.
I love it.
You can read.
I can do it. Yeah, you know, I know four different words, and Dino and Land are two of them.
Cheesies, I've just got in line for a dinosaur. I was going to do it with them, but it's quite a long line, and I've already done it twice this holiday with Sam, Dale, and Jesse, obviously, because it's Sam's favourite thing in the world. So I'm slipping out, I'm going to go to Coronado Springs and have a little chill, and then they're going to come and join me for said chill once they've got back to the resort and like got their swimming costumes and stuff. So we can just have a nice relaxing time, you know? This is when it gets hot, and today is quite warm, then you just need a bit of an afternoon nap or just some time to not be in a park. Do you know what I mean?
Welcome to Winged Encounter. The
trams have returned to Animal Kingdom, which is great to see. I think now they're actually back at all four theme parks. So if you wanted to save yourself a walk, very much appreciated. Thanks for bringing them back, Disney. Back at the resort, and I've just taken a little spot facing the lagoon. Chill out for a bit whilst I wait for Cheersies to arrive. Quick review of Coronado Springs. Overall, it gets a 4 out of 5 for me. The food options are really good. The room is amazing, and if you want to stay in a deluxe but that's not in your budget just yet, this is a really good option. The price was comparable to Port Orleans Riverside, so if you've stayed there before and you've maybe liked something a little bit more deluxe looking in terms of like lobby and food offerings, I would really, really recommend this resort. However, the reason it didn't get a 5 out of 5 was the transport options. I think if there was another option other than just the buses, this would have been a 5 out of 5, but the buses are very temperamental in terms of like, on one route you might be the first stop, so you'll definitely get a seat. On other routes, you might be the last stop, so you won't even get on the bus. And so if you were gonna be doing a lot of park days, like where you start and end the day, this is probably not the resort to stay at. If, however, like me on this trip, you're gonna do a very casual trip, you're looking to spend more time at the resort and go into the parks like halfway through the day, or you know, not the peak times, then I would really recommend it. So yeah, overall it's been really lovely, it's been really great for this trip. 4 out of 5. I just also thought this resort would really benefit from the Skyliner station that maybe took you to Animal Kingdom, or maybe just connected to Hollywood Studios or something like that. Hollywood Studios and Epcot are literally right there, they're a stone's throw away. And even if you potentially, because Pop Century is very close as well, maybe even if you just had a station that was like on the other side of Pop Century and Art of Animation station, and that came here and then went on to Animal Kingdom, that would then connect you to three different parks and also those other resorts to Animal Kingdom. So yeah, because there's a lot of people at this resort, especially when there's a convention on. This resort, when it's full, is very, very busy. Yeah. Transformed into my lovely greased swimming shorts. I'm heading over to the dig site, which is the main pool here. Cheers ears have since decided that they're gonna skip coming to Coronado because they were only just getting on the bus to Animal Kingdom. From Animal Kingdom, sorry. Which means that they'll be cutting it fine if we've got reservations at the Flying Fish later, which we do. So I'm gonna have my chill by the pool. And I'll go and meet them at the boardwalk later. Well, never mind. It looks like the pool is closed due to some cleanliness that needs to happen. Read into that what you will. But this is what it looks like. Well, can't say I didn't try. However, I have just found they have hammocks. This is the cabanas area. This is where me and Gary stayed in the past. There are vlogs on my channel if you want to go and check out what these look like, but I would also recommend my friend James Farrow's vlogs, because he vlogged this and he was actually here during the hurricane in 2022. So go and check him out. He's got some lovely content from this resort. And obviously they spent a lot of time here with the hurricane and everything. Since I'm trying to kill some time to give housekeeping a chance to do the room, I'm gonna head up to floor 16 and see if the Dolly Lounge is open. So that's Toledo. It looks amazing. Like, just the ceiling. So it's not open every single day of the week at the moment. So you do have to check the opening times before you start coming up here. Maybe book a reservation as well, because I'm assuming that during the conventions this gets very busy. Because it is really fancy. I love the fact they've even got trees indoors. But across the way is the Dahlia Lounge. Whilst the lounge is closed right now, I just thought I'd show you the view. And I was trying to work out where Riviera was from the view of my room. It's hiding behind the Swan and Dolphin Reserve. You can just about see it there. I've just changed into my dinner outfits because the Flying Fish is a signature. I didn't just necessarily want to go in what I've been wearing in the park during the day. And I think the Cheers Ears folks were thinking the same thing. So I put on a little polo as well as some trousers. And I've also ordered myself a minivan. Normally I wouldn't do a minivan for such a short distance. But with the Boardwalk, they're very funny about people arriving in Ubers / normal lifts. Just because they think that people are, or people obviously do, like come into the Boardwalk and then walk into the back of Epcot. So unless you have the reservation in your name or on your phone, they can sometimes turn you away. Whilst with a minivan, they're not going to do that. So it was expensive. It was $28. I'm not going to pretend it's not. But at the same time, I'm on holiday and I'm going to treat myself. Minivans do tend to take longer than other ride shares to actually arrive. So I've just requested this and they are about 10 minutes away. So just plan ahead when you're booking your minivan. I don't know what it is about this week, but this breeze has been so nice. It just makes it feel like even holiday even more, you know?
Hi, Adam.
Hi.
Good, how are you today?
Good, how are you?
Good, good. Just yourself?
Just myself.
All right.
Thank you very much. Ooh, Disney cartoons.
It'd be very lively here at the Boardwalk.
We like lively sometimes. Short, but sweet, and expensive. That's how I would summarize that experience. Minivan, they are really good. The cars are always very clean and the drivers are lovely. I had Dalton, he was really nice. So minivan, if you're watching, would recommend to a friend. But yeah, I would do it as a treat or like, for example, the scenario that I've had this evening. Just gonna pop in the Promenade Fine Art Gallery just to see if they've got any new pieces of art that I can wish I had. That's cute. These are lovely. Love this one. Ooh, they've even got ones on the Boardwalk. I need to find out who this artist is because I love the style and the stars and everything. Swarovski crystals in the frame. So what was her name again?
Denise Collette.
Denise Collette from Canada.
Yes.
This is such a nice resort area. The temptation to, like, the next time I stay in a deluxe to come back to this area. Are we excited about this meal?
I'm very excited.
Yeah?
I'm
very excited. I came here a long time ago and had a very nice meal then. So we're going to review it again.
Nice. It's exciting. I am very excited.
It's fancy. And it smells like fish.
There's the bar over there. There's an open kitchen, which is really nice. Here's a look at the menu. Tasting of artisan cheeses I'm gonna have. And then the red snapper, because our server talked about it and it sounds amazing. And it's the same price as the filet mignon, which is the same thing I was looking at.
Ooh! This is daily.
Yeah.
I like that was in unison, we almost harmonized. Oh!
Oh! What'd you get, Luke?
I got a Pacific Island fruit punch. And I'm going to give it a little bit of a taste.
Go, give it a little taste.
Oh, that's really nice.
Nice.
Would you like some?
Oh, go on.
Go on.
Would you like some? I like cooking crumble.
Creamy pine apples.
What do you think?
Nice. Really, that's really good. Nice. Lobster bisque. This is the cheese, and they've actually given me a little menu to actually see what it is. So if you're a cheese connoisseur, here's a look at what I'm having. It goes from mild to sharpest, so I'm going to be very brave here.
I don't know what they did with these cheeses, but not only are they all an amazing selection,
the accompaniments are outstanding. Honeycomb, something, and this like toffee crispy thing.
Would you like that?
Five star plus.
Wow.
Tracy, you had the shrimp cocktail. What do you think?
Five out of five.
There was the octopus. Shrimp cocktail.
3 out of 5.
Really?
It's nice.
Lobster bisque.
On a similar theme, I'm going to give my 4. It would have been a 3. But there was like a chunk of lobster in there, and it was unreal, and that pushed it to a 4.
Okay, cool.
But my favourite stays is octopus.
Luke and I have gone for a red snapper.
With a
snapper. A little scratch test.
Oh.
Enjoy your dinner, Alex.
Looks good.
Thank you, man.
Very good.
Filet mignon. What did you go for, Daisy?
Sea bass.
And I went for the seafood pasta.
Ooh.
I know, right?
A cocktail, a Coke. The snapper and the appetizer of cheeses with a 10% DVC discount came to $96.29 before tip. So it's not a cheap meal, but at the same time I would say that it's a high quality meal. Do you agree?
I would agree. Yeah. I would agree. Yeah, not cheap.
You wouldn't do it every holiday.
Special occasion.
What was the special occasion today?
Reunited.
There we go. Anything for an occasion.
Yeah, we can make an occasion.
Yeah. Well, it's also Daisy's birthday tomorrow. Hey!
Let's not forget, it was my birthday 5 months ago.
Anyway. That's flying fish. I think we all can get a consensus of 4 out of 5.
Yep.
4, 4, 4, 4, 4. Yeah. I can't put my finger on why it's not a 5 out of 5, but I think we're all in agreement. It was just expensive, nice meal.
Yeah.
It was
as a package, it's a 4.
Yeah, overall.
Overall.
Yeah.
Overall.
Yeah. Lovely server.
Nice.
Great spot. Superb company.
Oh, thanks.
Lovely.
Thanks, man.
Well, this is goodbye for now.
Goodbye for now.
Bye.
TTFN.
One of my favourite things about the Disney resorts is they play movies in the resort. So here in the boardwalk, they do it on the green, and they're currently showing Nightmare Before Christmas. How cool is that? Now to get my ride back to Coronado Springs. Well, what a lovely evening that turned out to be. Not that I was expecting anything less. I was with Cheers Ears, some of my favourite people in the world. That's gonna do it. That's it. Done. I definitely will stay here again. I think I mentioned earlier in this vlog that it's just missing some transport options. I would love if they had a Skyliner here. It would make the world of difference. And based on how close it is to the rest of the Skyliner system, I think it's doable. And I hope they do that. Even if it just connected to Animal Kingdom, it'd be so nice to be able to, you know, go somewhere without the ring road of the buses and everything like that. Disney World, room for improvement. I mean, things have been really good. Really, really good this trip. I haven't really had anything that I would say is bad. I'm trying to think. Prices. That's it, prices. I have noticed across the board, things are getting way too expensive. Like, to the point where I'm just like, I'm not gonna get a Mickey bar anymore. $6.50 for a Mickey bar. I was taken aback. I was. There is a limit, and when you're on vacation, I appreciate this is a once in a lifetime holiday. Obviously, you give yourself some allowances. For example, me taking a minivan earlier, like that's a treat. Taking a minivan is a treat.
There are some things that are just part of the holiday experience that I don't think should be priced as a treat, as it were. And yeah, there's a limit. We're already paying a lot to come here. We're already paying a lot for the hotel. And you know, all the other things that we have to pay for now, like Genie Plus and stuff like that. And I don't want to pay $6.50 for a Mickey bar, if I'm honest. So I just won't get one. That's ultimately what it comes down to. You know, I actually stop spending when the price is too high. And it's been the same with merchandise. The things that I am seeing and would potentially buy are just priced too high. And I appreciate price is very personal, but that's my perspective and my personal opinion. So what was my highlight of the trip? I'm going to say the first night that Sam, Dale, Jesse and I all went to Horror Nights, that was my highlight. It was such a fun evening. The vibe was there. I loved hanging out with them three. And yeah, it was just a lot of fun. I think that's going to do it. Hope you've enjoyed the series. Don't forget to tune in, like, subscribe, all that fun stuff for the series that's coming up next. So like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to see the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time.